Ja, hallo und herzlich willkommen. Ich bin jetzt mit dem Auto unterwegs und zwar fahre ich jetzt erstmal zum Flughafen. Also ich werde nicht selber jetzt fliegen, sondern ich werde jemanden abholen. Und zwar jemanden aus Schottland, einen sehr erfahrenen Ameisenhalter, der sich sehr gut mit Blattschalameisen auskennt. Ich werde mich mit Ihnen ein bisschen unterhalten und ihr dürft selbstverständlich dabei sein. Mein heutiger Gast ist Andrew Stevenson. Und hi Andrew.
Hello.
How was your flight?
And yeah, it was fine. Came in from Edinburgh. 2 hours. No problems.
Nice that you are here, and I'm very happy that we can talk about.
Well, thank you for having me. It's very nice to be here.
What was your first contact with your ants, and what was your first keeping ant species?
Well. I did research at university on social insects, and I wanted to keep a colony of ants, so I bought a colony of Atacephalotes from a professor in England and got my first colony in 1992 and kept those ants for a few years. Actually, the colony got very, very big, and they managed to get out of the nest in the summer when it was hot. And they went under the door of the building that they were in and removed all of the plants from my neighbor's garden and carried them all back in. And it was a disaster. And I had to move the colony to a zoo at that stage because it was too big. So it got to the stage where it was much too big. And that was my first encounter with Atacephalotes. And that kind of formed a lifelong love of them, which I've pursued ever since.
You are also an expert for the leafcutter ants. Why the leafcutter ants? Why you like this ant species?
Well, leafcutting ants are the most advanced of all the social insects. The things that they do, the way that their caste differentiations, the soldiers, the gardeners, how it's all laid out, it's incredible. Nobody could fail to be amazed by what you see when you look in these displays, and when you see them in a big public display in a zoo or a museum, and you see all the different elements of the colony, it's fantastic. I mean, in the tropics, in the wild, you see them, and they'll travel hundreds of meters to a plant and carry the leaves back. And the fact that they're not eating the leaves, the fact that they're using the leaves to grow a crop and then to feed on the crop and all the different elements of that, they are fantastic. So do you give them different leaves every day, or do you keep on black? Is that blackberry?
Yes. Yeah. Yes, normally we give this leaves. At this moment, it's very easy to get. The ants like it. And we use also dried flowers. So we have the ant farm for the wall.
Whoa, that's lovely. That's nice. I haven't seen that before. That's very nice.
Thank you.
So do you make that here as well? So you've got a CNC?
Yes.
Machine. Amazing. That's beautiful.
You tell me that you're often in Trinidad. Why? What is so special with Trinidad?
So the first colony of ants that I bought came from Trinidad.
Okay.
So I wanted to find where they came from. So I followed them back to Trinidad. And from then on, pretty much put down roots in Trinidad. I've built a house there. I spend several months a year. And in fact, at the end of this year, I'm going to move to Trinidad permanently and live in Trinidad and then travel to Europe to do the work that I do. So why Trinidad? They speak English. They drive on our side of the road.
Okay.
It's very UK friendly in Trinidad. So it's a nice place to be. My wife is Trinidadian, and the children, I have children who are half Trinidadian. So it's a place that I feel very comfortable. There's only two species of leaf-cutting ants there, Atacephalotes and Acromyrmex octospinosus. So in terms of variety, it's not fantastic, but in the rest of South America, there's plenty to see, and it's a good place to travel there from Trinidad to see it all. So yeah, Trinidad is an amazing place. I would recommend anybody come to Trinidad for a look.
Oh, nice, okay.
Yeah.
And you also travel in other countries. In which countries you was travel?
So virtually all of the South American countries, but Paraguay is where I'm concentrating now. I was there last year and trying to organize paperwork. Paperwork in South American countries is very, very difficult, and it's taken 18 months to finally sort that. So I'll be going to Paraguay this year to bring back lots of different species. And whereas there's only two species of leaf cutters in Trinidad, there's 22 species in Paraguay. So fantastic variety, including the grass cutting ants, which should be really good to see. So yeah, I'm looking forward to that. And I've managed to set up all the people that I need, the infrastructure, all the things that you need to be able to go there and get colonies.
Here is a strategy that birds don't find the nest, that they had not a street. Yeah, you see, here's the ant, they
okay.
Never a street.
So not a line of ants?
Yes.
All over, interesting.
So then we have here from South Europe, the Meso Barbaros. So they had here built a nest with corn and...
And they've dug that themselves, have they? Or is that a preformed...
No.
They've dug that.
Did you got problems with the keeping of leafcutter ants? And if yes, what or how did you fix it?
So we look at two parameters when we're setting up leafcutter ants: nice, even temperature and high humidity. So when we are setting up a display in a zoo, and we are talking to the client about looking after them, we say that you have to monitor the temperature and humidity in the fungus garden. So the humidity meter should have a probe that goes into the fungus, so you can satisfy yourself. It's amazing how if you measure the humidity even a little distance away from where the fungus is, it can be completely different. So we try to get them to measure the humidity in the where the fungus is. And the biggest problem with this type of display is that if you don't have lots of soil in the display, which a lot of people don't want because they want to see the fungus, if you don't have lots of soil, it can be quite difficult to keep the humidity and the temperature even. Sometimes with very small colonies, you don't hear that there's a problem until the colony's nearly dead and the fungus is gone. So you've got to get it right at the beginning. There's no time with small colonies to make mistakes often. And so people think that leaf-cutting ants are a difficult species. They're not a difficult species if you set it up properly. They're only a difficult species if it's not correct.
Okay.
So taking advice at the beginning from experts about how to set it up is critical. And do the research. Make sure that you do the research to know what you're talking about. I think it's really important.
We have an acrylic, which you see, what is very popular in the internet. I don't like it, but the customers like it. So we produce this nest.
Do you make these?
Yes, we have also, here's glass, and in backside we have for acrylic, the workshop. And we have here a special ground which saves the water, the humidity. What was your biggest adventure or experience about ants?
The adventures that you have with ants normally start once you've got the ants and you've got to try and move them across the world. But recently I was in French Guiana and I was on this huge mound of Atacephalotes. It was a massive big mound and it was quiet because you know they come out at night.
Yes.
And I wanted to see some activity. So I stood on the top of the mound and stamped my feet on it and nothing happened at all. And I was kind of confused as to why they weren't coming out. And I stepped back and all around the outside of this mound there was lots of tall grass. And what I didn't realise was all the soldiers, all the majors had come out and they were all over the grass. And I stepped back into them and I had shorts on, I had short trousers on. And my legs were covered in majors and covered in blood. because they just all bit, and it was a fright, a shock. And one of the biggest adventures, we did a program for the BBC in the UK called Planet Ants, and we were asked to go to the tropics and find 1 million ants in a colony and bring it back to the UK and film it in our studio. And it took us 2 days to dig this colony and find the queen. And we were bringing big handfuls of fungus gardens. There was 160 fungus gardens that we took. And we had a massive big box off camera, and we were putting all the fungus into the box. But what you didn't see on the camera was the box was covered in blood because we had gloves on. But within about half an hour, the gloves were all cut to pieces because the soldiers had cut the gloves. So we were lifting and putting in, but there was blood dripping in as well. It was very, very unpleasant.
Horror film,
yeah, it really was. But we did it. We got the queen. We found the queen at the end of the second day. We found the queen, and she was in the last fungus garden because they'd obviously moved her there. But she was surrounded by ants, so she was about the size of a mouse, but with all the ants around her. So we knew immediately we'd found the queen, and we could pick her up, and she was, it was huge, a big cocoon of ants, and we got her. So yeah, and that film now, I think you can see it on YouTube now. It's a couple hours long, and it's a fantastic documentary on leafcutting ants. Campanosis are a lovely ant, though, aren't they? They're a nice big chunky ant. Quite an attractive ant. Okay.
And here's the one nest.
Whoa.
Gibbs nest. And some people say with this material, it's maybe the ants can
grow. Do they?
But no. Yep. So we have tested with lots of ants, and we have now the material mixed that the ants cannot cut.
That is absolutely amazing.
And this nest is 1 year old. And you see it's very clean, you must clean it. And the wasp, the ants bring out to the last box. In front of us we have a starter kit, a setup which we sell for private customers. And what do you think about this? What is your feedback about this?
Well, all the elements that you need are here. The nest tank, the feeding area, and the waste, it's all there. And it's so easy to distinguish between all the different processes. You can see them cutting leaves, bringing it to the garden, and then taking the waste to the waste chamber. For a small scale private collector to have something like this in their home and to be able to see all the different things is fantastic, absolutely fantastic. I mean, I'm assuming you could extend the walkway if you wanted to, and you could have it a lot longer if you wanted to have the feeding area at a distance to the nest. You could have that. You could take it around a room as a setup. This is amazing. And the colony that's in there, I mean, if you want any proof that this is a good system, just look at how healthy that colony is. It's enormous. It's one of the biggest Acromyrmex colonies I've ever seen. When I see your setups, and I've seen these setups all over the world because people have come here and bought them and taken them back, and then I'll go along and see them. Most recently in a zoo in England, I saw some of your setups there, and they're obviously functioning very well, and they're doing, they're looking great.
So we have also option for B2B customers that they move this way, or you can change this the street, the ant way.
Wow.
Open close systems.
I like this. This is very nice. So and this is glass.
Yes.
Wow. So when you have a species on display, do you have smaller colonies offshore to sell?
Yes.
So they can say, I want this one, and then you can...
Yes, this is our showroom, so we can talk with other customers what is possible.
Uh-huh. And really, the size of this, you could make this any size, depending on what the people want. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So, Andrew, many thanks that you was here.
Thank you
was
very
happy, and I have a small present for you. And not really for you. No? You can look in the inside.
Oh, fantastic.
Some dry flowers for your ants.
Wow.
Maybe you can test it.
I've actually never used these before, but I've always seen them and I wondered, these are great.
our leaf cutter ends like more the red color, but you can check it.
Sometimes I will check.
Also change.
Amazing. Thank you very much. I appreciate that. Okay. Thank you.
Many thanks. Ja, ich hoffe, das Interview hat euch soweit gefallen. Also vielen Dank, dass ihr dabei wart und ich freue mich auf das nächste Video.